السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of CII Radio, we present to you lesson number 714 of our daily Nasiha. Our topic today is Egypt. Egypt in Arabic is known as Misr, and this word is mentioned in the Noble Quran several times. When did Egypt become a Muslim country as we understand it? Remember, it was on the 1st of Ramadan, the 20th year after the Hijrah. Amr bin As radiallahu an, who is known as Fatih Misr, the conqueror of Egypt, conquered Egypt. Subhanallah, we are now in 1439. So if you take it in that way, so many years, 1,400 years plus, Egypt is an Arab country, a Muslim country, and has made great contribution towards Islam and the Muslims. Let us see, when one goes to Egypt, which are the places one should visit. Number one, go visit Masjid Amr bin As. This masjid was, as I mentioned, that Egypt was conquered by Amr bin As. Sahaba radiallahu an, 70, 80 of them sat there, made mashura, had consultation regarding the direction of the Qibla, and now, mashallah, the masjid has been renovated, very big, very beautiful, and the history of the masjid also is written there in Arabic. Similarly, go visit Al-Azhar University, more than 1,000 years old. And remember, it was in that university, in the good old days, Allama Suyuti Rahimahullah and so many other great scholars of Islam who were masters in every field were lecturers and teachers there. Similarly, one can go to Al-Husayn, and that is just opposite the Al-Azhar Masjid and University, and that also is a big masjid. Some people, but it's not authentic, they say Sayyidina Hussein radiallahu anhu's head Mubarak is buried there, but that is not 100% authentic. Likewise, next to that you will find Khan-e Khalil. Khan-e Khalil is one of the biggest markets you will find in Africa. So big, mashallah. And you will find bargaining is part of the deal. You have to bargain. And anything and everything almost you will find there in Khan-e Khalil. Likewise, another important place is the papyrus factory. And you go there, you will find the papyrus on which they write Quranic verses or poetry and so forth. So that is something very, very great. Obviously, people speak about the pyramids. Yes, one can go there. And remember, the history of it, Allah alone knows. But you need to be very careful if you want to go inside. Because once you go inside, then there are no windows and so forth. They will even warn you and tell you that once you start to have difficulty in breathing, then you better come out quickly. So in that way, you go and visit the pyramids as well. Likewise, if you want to visit the Pharaonic Museum, and this is the miracle of the Noble Quran, Almighty Allah Jalla Wala informs us, فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ لِتَكُونَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةٌ, that Pharaoh, Fir'aun, the Pharaoh of Nabi Musa alayhi salam's time, who killed thousands of children, Allah alone knows. And we must remember that he enslaved thousands of people as well. So he, Almighty Allah, drowned him and preserved his body so that it becomes a lesson for humanity and for posterity. So you go to the Pharaonic Museum and you can see that as well. Other important places you can visit in Cairo as well, and you can go to the libraries and so forth. Then you can go to Alexandria. They have a massive, massive library there. And another place in Egypt is Mount Sinai. I climbed right to the summit and the peak, alhamdulillah, with my wife. So those of you who want to go there's a lot of security, but it is something worth undertaking. And subhanallah, when you're at the summit, at the apex, and there you make dua to Almighty Allah, That is the place in that area Nabi Musa alayhi salatu salam went to, Nabi Isa alayhi salatu salam will go to. Waturi Sinin, Almighty Allah took a qasam on it, Mount Sinai. So inshaAllah we should try and visit these places. Udukhulu Misra inshaAllah aminin, enter Egypt, Allah willing, with peace and tranquility, great history. May Almighty Allah protect Egypt and the Muslims and the people who are working for the upliftment of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.